Bethany Murungi, a former pupil of Bishop Asili Memorial Nasarawa Primary School, had become the center of a legal battle. Her father, Tadeo Ruzindantaro, represented by his lawyer Timothy Twikirize of Twikirize and Company Advocates, filed a lawsuit against the school in the Kabale High Court under the Civil Suit Number 36 of 2022. He accused the school of allowing Nimurungi to be taken by her estranged mother, Mercy Chirande, without his consent. In April 2018, Chirande, currently residing in South Africa, requested permission to take their child to Kampala for medical treatment due to stomach complications. However, she failed to return Nimurungi to the school, triggering a legal dispute. Yesterday, SCP Fred Enanga, the Uganda police spokesperson, informed the press that the child and her caretaker, Fiona Rukundo, were located in Kampala through extensive police efforts. Investigations unveiled that Mercy Chirande, along with her friend Fiona Rukundo, had taken the child from the school in Kabale district.
Rukundo is the caretaker. We need a statement from the mother of the victim, who's still in South Africa, who was used in a shelter home. What was important was, first of all, tracing and recovering the victim. For the whole of the 5 years, try as much as possible to locate the victim after the mother went to return to South Africa without her. So we managed to...
Rukundo was arrested on 23rd of this month, while Nimurungi is currently detained at the Chibuli CID headquarters in Kampala. Rukundo has been released on police bond, and both individuals will be transported to the Kabale Central Police Station for further legal proceedings. The school's head teacher, Reverend Sister Margaret Tusime, expressed immense relief at the child's recovery.
I am rejoicing that God does not allow evil to continue in his people. This is the man who decided to sue the school that the child was taken away by unknown people. Yet it was his true wife who he wedded with, who took the child and who was responsible also in paying school fees and caring for the child. After a week, when the father complained, he straight away issued the case to court, of which I have to say I am grateful to the school management, and I am announcing this to the public that this child has been got, and the person who stole is also in cell as I talk now. Mine is to thank God and thank the school management and you parents for having been very understanding that the evil has short legs, and may God be pleased. Thank you so much.
We believe that there must be a connection between the person who was looking after the child and the mother who took the child from the school. Because the mother now is in South Africa, but the child was being looked after by her friend, I would imagine, in Kampala, right from around P6 to S1 now. The child should be now around S1.
However, Tadeo Ruzindantaro, the child's father, continues to hold the school accountable for releasing his child without the parents' consent.
Nyowe ndahulira ndashasha munonga. Amani ganje garashasha kandi ndahulira gali.
I am deeply disheartened and disappointed to discover that after enduring immense pain during the search for my child, the school is now publicly celebrating a milestone while claiming a role in the child's recovery, despite our perception that it contributed nothing to the search. If the school asserts its involvement in finding my child, I earnestly request that they provide evidence to substantiate their claims. The legal battle surrounding this case is expected to continue as more details emerge. Report by Job Namanya in Kabale for the news.